tanong ko, Senator Jinggoy, matagal ka ng senador. Did that come as a surprise to you considering you had Senate President Mig Zubiri in effect fighting for Bato's right to hold that hearing, the PDEA leaks hearing, and that's the hearing that they say tipped the scale. I mean, it changed his fortune. What are your thoughts?
It changed what?
It changed the fate of Senate President Mig Zubiri.
No, that is not true. That is quite irrelevant. So the investigation of the PDEA leaks has nothing to do with the ouster of Senator Zubiri.
Is that right? So, Senator Jinggoy, you have to shed some light here. If it's not the PDEA leaks hearing, it could be, of course, accumulation of events. But what is it then? You don't just oust a leader if all of you are happy.
But as I told you, Karen, and during my previous interviews, we have discussed it. I have discussed it with Senator Escudero, and I'm not in the proper position to divulge what we have discussed in public.
Okay. Now, how was your dinner last night with President Marcos Jr.? He invited all the senators to, I think, have dinner. And I'm curious, who was there? How many of you were there, Senator?
Majority of the senators were there, except group of Senator Zubiri. But Senator Loren de Garda was also there, was also present last night during the dinner.
I see. And so it was, I know, seven, I believe, tama ba ko, Senator? No, seven didn't vote and stayed with Migs. So tama ba to, Senator? No, of the seven, you have Senator Loren de Garda who went to Malacanang last night.
The two minority senators were absent, named Senator Coco and Senator Lisa Federos. And of course, Senator Mix was not there. Senator JD is not there too. Senator Angara, Senator Binay. Yes. And I forgot.
Okay. And what happens now, Senator Jinggoy? You're the Senate pro tempore. Is it important for this leadership to have the seven in the majority? Because maganda yung sinabi, sir, ni former Senate President Drilon. Pag yung pito na yun, umanib at kumampi sa minority, magiging siyam ang minority at napakalaki nun. What are your thoughts?
Well, we still have to await for whatever decision that the so-called independent bloc will make. No, either they join the minority or they remain as an independent bloc.
Okay.
Or the silent majority.
Okay. Now, let's move on to the Alice Go hearings. So I know, tama ba, Senator, you have a hearing today, tama?
Yes. That is going to be chaired by Senator Rizal Riveros.
Yeah. But will you be at the hearing, sir?
Yes, I still have another hearing which I am going to chair as the chair of the Committee on National Defense regarding the wiretapping. So kailan maglagari siguro.
Oh. Okay, lalagari ka today. So I want to get your thoughts, no, on Banban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go. I interviewed her and suddenly in a surprise teleserye-like plot twist, she says her mother was their house help. Kumbaga, anak siya ng kasambahay nila. Nung iniluwal daw siya, kinuha siya ng kanyang ama, itinago sa farm, at a teacher was coming over essentially because parang itinago rin dahil anak daw siya ng kasambahay. So that's one aspect of her personal life. Do you believe that, Senator Jinggoy?
It's quite ridiculous, Karen. Although I was not there during the first hearing because I was busy attending another hearing, I am quite interested if I hope Mayor Alice Go will attend this morning's hearing. I'm quite interested with what she has to say yet again.
But do you believe that? I'm curious, or you're keeping yourself open?
Well, I'll give her the benefit of the doubt because there are a lot of questions that she has to answer.
Okay.
I heard
now,
that she does not know her mother. She does not have any birth certificate. The birth certificate was registered 17 years after. That's quite absurd.
Okay. You've mentioned two main points. Okay, important points. Next is her supposed links to Pogo. So she's insisted in our interview that she's essentially made money of Pogo with the rental of her land and the sale of the land. She keeps insisting she is not a partner of Pogo, and she invited Pogo essentially to create more jobs and income for the town. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, you know, Karen, I haven't heard her say that, but I heard from a very, very reliable source that the operation of the Pogo in her town, the one operating it or managing it or handling it, is her partner.
Mm-mm.
And
Uh-oh.
Incidentally, her partner is also a public official.
Is that right? Can you say the name of what was given to you?
Well, maybe during the hearing, Karen.
Okay. So, because what's interesting, this is a new angle, is she was accused of having a partner when it comes to the Baufu compound, who's a fugitive, right? And Senator Risa Ontivero says she has links to criminals, and one of the partners that was registered was arrested in Singapore for money laundering. But what you are saying is she is a partner in the operations of Pogo, and isa pang politiko ang kasama niya.
Yes,
Politiko sa probinsya, Senator.
Partner to negosyo and partner, parang live-in partner.
Partner sa negosyo at live-in partner, meaning partner sa buhay.
Yes.
That's quite okay. You won't tell us who he is?
Well, maybe during the hearing, Karen.
Okay, all right. All right. Okay, so that moves it forward. So as we close this interview, I just want to ask you, Senator, are you for Pogo or against Pogo? Because the bigger issue here, yung dalawang na-raid na Pogo, and I hope this gets to Malacanang, yung dalawang na-raid na Pogo sa Bamban, na may human trafficking, may mga biktima, may armas, dalawa po yun, Senator, may PAGCOR license. So, sinasabi ni Alice Go, may PAGCOR license yan eh. Yung itinayo dyan eh. Lisensyado yan ang PAGCOR. So, the bigger issue is, why can't we just ban Pogo? Are you for the banning of Pogo, Senator Jinggoy?
Well, right now, during my previous interviews, maybe early, late last year, with regard to Pogo, lagi ko po sinasabi, I am for Pogo just as long as it is licensed by PAGCOR, because it can generate jobs, no? But yung mga hawshaw, yung mga kolorum na Pogo, kailangan na matanggal na lahat yan, no? Because me, I was after the generation of jobs for our people. Now, because of these events, basically, I implied to ban Pogo here in the Philippines.
Because of what comes with it, right? I mean, at the end of the day, even if it has a PAGCOR license, it comes with human trafficking, prostitution. It seems with the two raids that were conducted and scams.
Hello.
Okay. Yeah. Senator, before we close, is there anything you would like to add before we go?
Well, rest assured, Karen, that the new leadership in the Senate will do everything possible to, of course, to support all the LEDAC bills, which is the priority bills of the administration. And rest assured that we will remain independent. We'll protect and fight for the independence of the Senate as an institution.
All right. On that note, I hope to have you once again on Head Start. Senate President Pro Tempore Jinggoy Estrada, thank you for joining me today, sir.
Thank you, Karen.